हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू सॉल्ट एनालिसिस ऑफ सॉल्यूशन नंबर 13 एंड दिस इज योर ओएस ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन नंबर 13. सो हियर वी स्टार्ट विद अवर सॉल्ट एनालिसिस विद द फर्स्ट दैट इज प्रिलिमिनरी टेस्ट. राइट, इन दैट फर्स्ट टेस्ट इज दैट इज कलर. यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व द कलर ऑफ द ओएस. एज यू कैन सी योर ओएस कलर इज ब्लू. So in your observation, you have to write down that is blue. And in inference that is Cu+2 may be present. Next we have litmus test. So here first I'll take blue litmus paper. I will dip litmus paper into OS and check. And as you can see, your blue litmus paper turns into red. I'll check for the another litmus paper, that is red one. And you can see there is a no change. So in litmus test, your observation is blue to red. It means salt of strong acid and weak base is present. Okay. For the flame test, first of all you have to clean your platinum wire with your concentrated HCl solution. So dip your platinum wire into HCl solution and heat it. This process you have to do 2 to 3 times. So after cleaning platinum wire, you have to take mixture of OS plus HCl. You can use concentrated HCl. Here we added small amount of acid. In that we will add OS and this mixture we will heat into flame and observe the color of the flame. So you can observe there is a slight bluish green color flame you will observe. So your flame color is bluish green color. So as you observe bluish green color flame, your inference is that Cu+2 may be present. For borax B test, first of all you have to make a loop by twisting this platinum wire. After that you have to heat this platinum wire and dip into borax powder. So maximum amount of borax powder will catch with the platinum wire and they will form a bead. Bead should be transparent. It has a glass like structure. So as you can see, your bead become transparent. So now you have to dip this bead into your OS solution. So now we have to dip bead into OS solution and we heat it. Here we have to do a strong heating. You have to dip 2 to 3 times bead into OS solution and you have to do a strong heating.
After that, you have to observe the color of the bead. So after, you have to do a strong heating. You have to observe the color of the bead. So this is the color of your bead, and you will get a bluish green color. So your so this is your bead color. So in your observation you have to write down, that is, your bead color is bluish green color. So this is your bead color, and your inference should be Cu+2 may be present. After finishing borax bead test, you have to break this bead from the platinum wire. And how will you break? You have to do strong heating, and as your bead becomes red hot, you have to jerk the platinum wire, so bead will release from the loop. So as you can see, your bead will go off. So next we have, that is, B part. It's a wet test for positive radical. In that, our first test is OS plus dilute HCl. So let's check. So here I will take a small amount of OS in test tube. In that I will add dilute HCl solution, and you observe that you have clear solution. It means no precipitates. So in your observation, that is, no precipitates, and inference will be first group is absent, and Pb+2, Ag+, Hg+2, they are also absent. Next test is OS plus dilute HCl plus H2S. In previous test tube, I have already OS plus HCl into, I will add H2S, that is hydrogen sulfide. And you can see here we get black color precipitates. It means that our second group is present. So in your observation, you have to write that black precipitates and second group is present. And either in my OS, either will be Cu+2, Cd+2 or Sn+2 may be present. So after finding a group, we have to do analysis, that is group analysis. So here I will take analysis of group 2 on your test is, that is, OS plus NaOH plus heat. So here I will take a small amount of OS into test tube. In that I will add NaOH, sodium hydroxide. See, after adding NaOH to the test tube, you can see that here we get blue precipitates. Now I will heat the solution. You can see after heating, the blue precipitates which I have, that convert into black precipitates. So that is your observation. Okay, so you get that blue precipitates turns black on heating. It means that Cu+2 present. Now we have to confirm that Cu+2 is present or not. So for that, we are going to do, that is, confirmatory test for Cu+2.
Okay. So our next part is, that is confirmative test for Cu2+. Right. In the first test, you have OS plus NH4OH, that is ammonium hydroxide. So let's see what happened after adding NH4OH.
So here I will take a small amount of OS into the test tube. In that I will add NH4OH. So here I will take a small amount of OS. In that I will add ammonium hydroxide, that is NH4OH. See, if you add NH4OH, you will get blue precipitates. But whenever you add into excess of amount, then that blue precipitates which you have, that will dissolve and it will give you a deep blue coloration that you can see. So here I will add excess of amount of NH4OH. So you can clearly see the blue precipitates which you have, that will dissolve in excess of NH4OH and you will have deep blue coloration.
So observation, that is blue precipitates dissolve in excess giving deep blue coloration, it means Cu+2 is confirmed. Our next test is OS plus K4FeCN6. If you get brown precipitates, it means Cu+2 confirmed. So let's check.
So here I will take small amount of OS into test tube. In that I will add K4FeCN6, that is potassium ferrocyanide, and you observe that you will get brown precipitates. It means Cu+2 is confirmed.
So Cu+2 confirmed. So in my OS, my positive radical is Cu+2. So now we move towards the negative radical. For the negative radical, first we start with our wet test for negative radical. In that, first test is OS plus AgNO3. If you get white precipitates, then Cl- may be present. If you don't get, then Cl- is absent.
So here I will take a small amount of OS into test tube. In that I will add AgNO3 and observe it. And you can see here you don't get any precipitates, you have clear solution. So it means that Cl- is absent.
So now we move towards the sulfate ion test, that is OS plus BaCl2. If you get white precipitates, then SO4-2 may be present. If you don't get white precipitates, then sulfate ion is absent.
So here I will take small amount of OS into the test tube. In that I will add BaCl2, that is barium chloride. And you observe that you have clear solution. It means that SO4-2, that is sulfate ion, is also absent.
Now we move towards the third ion, that is NO3-, that is nitrate. So for that you have to take OS plus copper foil plus concentrated H2SO4 and heat. If you get brown fumes of NO2 gas, then NO3- may be present.
So here I will take small amount of OS into the test tube. In that I will add copper foil. In that I will add copper foil into the test tube. After adding copper foil, I will add concentrated H2SO4. I will heat this solution. So as you can see, on heating on heating you get brown fumes. Brown fumes of NO2 gas. It means NO3 minus may be present.
So here in my wet test, I will get NO3 minus may be present. So I will confirm NO3 minus with the help of confirmatory test. So confirmatory test for NO3 minus is that is you have to take OS plus concentrated H2SO4, then you have to cool under the tap water and slowly you have to add freshly prepared FeSO4.
So here I will take small amount of OS into test tube. In that I will add concentrated H2SO4. As you add H2SO4, temperature of the solution will be increased. So we have to cool this solution under the tap water. So after complete cooling of the solution, you have to add freshly prepared FeSO4 from the side of the test tube. See, you have to add FeSO4 from the side of the test tube. You have to wait for some time. So as you can see here, you get that is a brown unstable ring at the junction. So this ring suggested that NO3 minus is confirmed.
So NO3 minus is confirmed. So here I concluded that in my OS, Cu+2 as a positive radical and NO3 minus as a negative radical is present. And hence my solution is copper nitrate, and the formula of copper nitrate is CuNO3 twice.